mali uko sahi na ukiangalia wale watu wamekunguka kwa community yako, do you feel boys na girls ama male youth na female youth wote wako equal in terms of ku achieve their potential? So on the same question, boy who are 17 years ame have sex for the first time na dem amepata ball, nani ako na chances za kuendelea na life na masomo na nini na nini? Then wakireach 24, huo boy atakuwa wapi? Kwa assume yes aliendelea na education, atakuwa wapi? So yeye akiwa 24 ndio sasa labda kwa campus, but boy ashaanza kufanya nini? Kuwaka. Hizo ndio gaps na try kusema tunafaa tuangalie ni nini inafanya madem mtaani wa fulfill hizo potential yao.
We are looking at how we can do a qualitative research on the livelihood gender gaps within Mathare sub county. I work with the marginalized community, the deaf, and that's why I could resonate with what's happening on the ground in Mathare. And basically we have a team of research assistants who will be on the ground, so my work was to basically train them, develop the tools that they will use. So the training was for them to understand the tools better, for them to collect data, to do it in the right way, and to get enough data that can help us now come up with a report in terms of an analysis of the situation on the ground, whether it's true or not, without any bias, so that we can be able to come up with now projects which will be intervention projects for what's happening.
What is research? Because me ile nimeandika kutoka kwa kitabu ni gathering, recording, analyzing information basically to solve a problem. There has to be an end goal for the research. So if you want to do a sample size for, let's say, Kenya, you're only supposed to talk to about 1,800 Kenyans. And we'll know exactly what Kenyans are talking.
My expectations for this project is to enjoy, first of all, to enjoy and to interact with everyone that is involved in this project, and to also get to learn more about the community that I'm working with, because you are doing research in Mathare, so I'm going to learn. I want to learn more about the livelihoods of the people in Mathare and trying to find what's the problem, why is it that there's a gap between livelihoods of both male and female.
My expectation of the ongoing project, we would like to identify the different development projects for the youths in Mathare, which I believe is going to help and improve the lives of youths within this area.
It has been a fine day with icebreakers and the key basic information about how to become a data collector and a research assistant, which was very much helpful to our research assistant. Now, what I expect from our research assistant is that when they go to field, they collect real-time data that will help focus on our intervention. You know, over the past, we've been implementing programs without really knowing the real situation in the ground. But back to this project, Livelihood Gender Gaps, will know what are some of the issues that are facing youths, basically, or mostly female youths, that they don't arise to occasion whenever issues of Mathare is being discussed.
My name is Joshua Cheng, project administrator of Livelihood Gender Gaps Research in Mathare. The research is being carried out in three specific areas in Mathare: Mabatini Hospital and Mlango Kubwa Ward. It is assumed that equal opportunity is given to both male and female, but yet the success stories of the female is so low. So we want to see how we can be able to bridge that gap that has been left there.
Wewe kama boy kulia already ni kama makosa kwao. So umefika hapo, umeona watu wenye unataka kuongelesha, umekuwa emotionally, unaanza kutoa machozi, wameanza kucheka. Utakuwa drawn, hata utasema anything.
Today I had an interview. It was conducted by Pamoja Initiative. Their main aim was to understand the gender gaps in our communities, and as an individual, I'm looking forward to see the interventions that will come up after the research and after they compile all the reports that they will gather during this time that they are doing the research.